Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I will be teaching you how to make this Mickey Mouse hat. This fits for a baby of 1 year. I have given instructions about the measurements of this hat. So even if you are using a different sized hook, please measure your work before you finish it. So the materials that we will be needing to make this project are the crochet hooks of 3 mm, 2.5 mm and 4.5 mm. I have changed the sizes depending upon what part of the hat I am crocheting. Along with that, you will need a measuring tape, a sewing needle and scissor, and the main colors, red and black yarn. Along with that, you will need 2 buttons, preferably yellow color. So these are all the materials that you need to crochet this hat. So let's get started. I will start making the hat by making a magic ring. I am using 3 mm crochet hook here and 12 double crochets in the center. Here are my 12 double crochets. Now I will complete this round by a slip stitch on top of the first double crochet, and I will pull this tail to close the center. So the center is closed now. Now going to the second round, I will make chain 3. I will count this chain 3 as my first double crochet. Then I will make one more double crochet in the same stitch. This will be an increase. And in every stitch, I will be making 2 double crochets. That is, I will be increasing in every stitch. So at the end of this round, you should have 24 double crochets. So this is 2 double crochets in each stitch. Continue making till the end and join with a slip stitch to complete this round. Round 2 is over. Round 3, begin by making chain 3 and a double crochet increase in the same stitch. So round 3 continues as an increase and an individual double crochet. Basically, we are following the pattern of a flat circle, and I am going to continue making the flat circle till its diameter is 4.5 inches. So please refer the video of making flat circles and follow the same pattern, but begin by making a magic circle here. So complete it and we will meet after that. I completed making the 6th round. Now at this point we will stop increasing. Now the work measures 4.5 inches. So after this point we will be just making 1 double crochet in each stitch. I have started with chain 3, which counts as first double crochet. Next, 1 double crochet in each. Continue this till the end and continue this, making 1 double crochet in each stitch till the height of the hat reaches about 4 or 4.5 inches. After that we will make some changes. Now my work measures 4.5 inches. So to reach this height, I made 13 rounds of double crochet. Next, the changes that we are going to make is we will shift to red color. So change the color and continue making only one row of double crochet now. Make only one row of double crochet. Next, we will see what to do. One round with red color making double crochets is over. Now to go to the next round, make chain 3, and in the next stitch, that is in the next double crochet of the previous round, make a front post double crochet, and in the next stitch make a back post double crochet. Okay, so this gives ribbing to this hat. Next will be front post double crochet. Back post double crochet. So you have to continue the same entire round, one front post double crochet, one back post double crochet. If you don't know how to make front post and back post double crochet, I have already made a video on that. Please check the link in the description. I will update the link. Continue this for the entire round. Now you have to end this round by joining on top of chain 3 that we made at the beginning, not on this double crochet. So this is chain 1, chain 2 and chain 3. So I will join at this point with a slip stitch. Next, we will make chain 3 again for the next round and again continue making front post and back post double crochets till the work reaches 6.5 inches. Now it is 5.25. I should make one more inch, that is till 6.5 inch. So complete this much and then we will see what to do. I completed making the rounds of front post double crochet and now my work measures 6.5 inches height and the circumference. It is about 8 inches, that is 16 inches circumference. So this is suitable for a baby of 1 year. Now next we will be making ear flaps. I have made one of the ear flap. So after you finish your work, you can start making one ear flap wherever you want. But for the second one, you have to make exactly opposite of it. So when I have made one, I will just see which is the center point for the other one, like this. So this will be the center point. To make it easier, I have marked the center one, center stitch with a safety pin. You can use stitch markers. Now I will count 6 stitches from here and 6 stitches from here and I will mark them. So I have marked them. Now I will remove the center pin. I will be continuing with red color only. So I will join the red color to this stitch, which is the back post double crochet. Now after you have joined the stitch, make a chain 1, chain 2 and you just make double crochets, front post and back post double crochets till you reach this mark point. Continue with the same design. After you make 13 front post and back post double crochets, make a chain 2, turn your work. Now you have to crochet them in opposite manner. The one which was front post here, that will be back post here. So you should make that a back post double crochet. And the ones which were back post here, they will be front post here. So again you make them front post double crochet. Continue this till the end. So here the stitch, the front post double crochet which was from the back side, we have made it back post. And the first stitch where we started was back post double crochet. And see here we are barely able to see it because we did a chain 2. So now instead of doing a front post, you just make a double crochet in this space. Okay, make a double crochet in this space and turn your work, make chain 2, 1, 2. Now we will start to decrease to give it a triangular shape. So the first stitch will be a front post double crochet, but we will make 2 stitches together. Those 2 stitches will be the first front post and the second back post. Both of them together we will make it as a front post double crochet. Okay, now those 2 turned as 1 stitch. Crochet the remaining stitches as they are, front post, back post. There will be some changes at the last again. Till last 3 stitches are remaining, crochet the same. Now last 3 stitches are remaining, 1 back post, 1 front post and 1 more, chain 2. So now you have to make a front post double crochet using these 2 stitches, which is the next back post and a front post. So make them one front post double crochet together. Next will be a double crochet in that chain space. So in this round we decreased 2 stitches. Now make chain 2 and turn. So here again we will decrease. Here these 2 stitches they show backwards, that is, they are the back post double crochets. Now we will make these two together in the back post manner itself. Two stitches together, we decreased one stitch again and crochet the same till the last three stitches are remaining. So last three stitches are remaining, again one back post, one front post and one back post. So these two stitches, one back post and one front post, they will be made as one back post double crochet, two together like this, and last one will be a double crochet in this chain space. Again in this round we decreased two stitches, next round chain two, again make two more decreases by using these two stitches, which is a front post and a back post. Make them one front post together, front post double crochet together. Next will be a normal front post double crochet and the next stitch will again be a decrease, making two front post double crochets together. Last one as it is, that is a double crochet. Okay, now again chain two and turn. Now we have three stitches in between. So what you will do is take the first stitch in the back post manner, skip the second, take the third stitch in the back post manner and make a back post double crochet together. Next will be a double crochet as it is. Okay, so here only three stitches are remaining. Now this is how it looks like. Now chain two and repeat this round. This is the chain two as it is. This one will be the front post double crochet and a double crochet in this space. Okay, now this completes the ear flap. Now we will make this cord. It is very simple cord. Now turn back and make a slip stitch into this stitch here, into the previous stitch, so that our loop lies at the center. Now to make this tie or the cord, I have used three layered yarn, but now we have only one here. So for that we are going to take two more layers of the same yarn. Don't cut it anywhere, just measure about 30 inches with your measuring tape. After you measure 30 inches, it is a continuous one, you can see I have not cut it anywhere. So this loop you will carry with the next stitch from here like this. So there will be two loops on the hook now and three strands lying behind. Now you're going to do 21 chain stitches with this, as it is a three layered one. This hook size will be very small for that. So I will be using 4.5 mm hook and I will make 21 chains. 2, 3. After making 21 chains, cut the working end of the yarn and draw the strands out, tighten it and the cord is ready. We will see how to make this tassel. For that, I have joined the two colors and again I have cut them about 30 inches in length. Now join them, fold them two times, three times and four times. This is how it looks. Now you have to draw them all together from here, from the last chain that we made. Okay, after you pull them, pass all these strands in this loop along with these which we finished the work with, and make a knot by pulling these tails. Now cut the loops and level it with the other tassel that we have already made. Keep them equal in length. So this is ready now. Now the next part of the hat is remaining, that is, we have to make the ears for this. To make the ears, I have made flat circle and this measures 3 inches. One more thing, I have used 2.5 mm hook for this because I wanted the stitches to be as close as possible and smaller in size. So I have used a smaller sized hook. You have to make 4 such circles, 2 for each ear. Let's make the first ear. So to begin that, you have to first notice which is the front side and which is the back side of your work, and join the two parts together. Backs should face each other and the front should face outside for both the circles, and start joining them together with single crochet or with slip stitch, however you choose it. I will close by making slip stitch all around. Go under 2 loops of one circle and 2 loops of the next circle and make a slip stitch. Don't just carry one loop from each and don't skip any stitch. Continue this till at least 8 to 10 stitches are remaining. Okay, leave a small gap and complete it till here. Okay, so these stitches are remaining. Don't close it, don't finish your work yet. So this is the gap that we have left. Now you can fill some fillers in it like this, Recron, to give it a fluffy finish. Just fill as much as it can hold. Okay, this much would be enough. Continue making slip stitches. Okay, last stitch I have done, and I will join it with the slip stitch to complete. Chain 1, and before you cut, leave at least 10 to 11 inches of tail, and then you cut it. So this completes first ear. Okay, now we will attach the ear to the hat. So choose where you want to attach. I will attach it at the end of third round and at the beginning of fourth round. So I will attach it for 3 rounds, that is till here. That much is necessary, otherwise the ear will fall off. So start attaching from the beginning of fourth round. 1, 2, 3, and this is the fourth round. So attach it from here. You should stitch, take one stitch from here, and you should insert it to the double crochet stitch of the hat. Okay. Now we will finish it by making a knot, a simple knot. For that, insert it towards the inside of the cap. Make a knot here. Later on, cut this tail. So this is the first ear that we have attached. Now repeat the same for the second ear also. I have completed making the hat. I have attached the ears. I have also attached a bow. You can see the link in the description on how to make this bow, and also I have attached 2 buttons. So this completes making the hat. I hope you like this video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.